think you all have sometimes the problem, you cannot remember something, you want to memorize a number or the shopping list, and on the way to the store you forget what you want to buy. And instead of writing this, you can also memorize this with some tricks. I have some techniques how you can memorize easier, for example, numbers. My goals are you know the basics of the major system. It's an easy way to memorize numbers. Then the second goal is you learn the basics of linking. It's a general method which you use in many many methods of memorizing techniques. Then the method of locking. You have the first method. You learn. You use this for little numbers, but with this you can save big data, big numbers like with 200 letters, 200 digits inside, and also some dates for school exams, and then a short thing about language learning, how you can easier learn vocabulary. So the major system. Try to memorize this number. Very short. You have not much time. When I give you 1 minute to memorize this, who would be able to memorize this for at least 5 minutes? No? It's so easy. So it's difficult to remember, but if you know the technique, it's easy. So if we translate this to the major system, it means naked pilots cook tortellini in the cockpit. So you take every digit and tell more about later. You create a sentence or then an image, and you memorize this image, and it's studies proven that you can easier remember images than such numbers. So the major system, it works like you have 0 to 9 and have some consonants here. For the 0 you have the set, like set 0, you can memorize this like this, and the rest is like similar than set. Then the 1 is like T, it looks like a T, and the D sounds like a T. Then the 2, it is N. N has 2 times, is 2 times on the ground. The 3 is the M, it's 3 times on the ground. The 4 looks a bit like a 4, and if you take the last letter from 4, it's an R. The 5, it's L. L is also the in the Roman digits, it's the number 50, so you can remember this like this. Then the 6 is in the German you can say, what do you call it now? But this is then 7, it looks like a K if you twist it. The 8 is like a German old F, and U is also like same like F, and the 9 is just P in the mirror. So, and then you have the unassigned, like the H, J, and W, and the vowel sounds. So this is the basic rules, and I have this also here. I will show you this on an example. This is more like near. So, an example. We want to translate 52 to a word. So you take 5, it's like L, sorry, 5 like L, and 2 is N, like 2 times on the ground. And then you try to fill this gap between, and you can also, after these two consonants, add some vowels, some H, some J, and W. And does somebody know what this could be if you add vowels inside and H, a word, yes?
Lion, for example.
Lion, that's a good example.
I didn't know the shoot.
I think he is the seer.
You're correct.
So, the exercise. I have some numbers for you, and I want you to try the system. So, if somebody knows the first number, just...
Man.
Man could be possible. It's also moon. You can use many different words. And then you can choose what it's for you the best, and you can memorize this word. This is just like a help to memorize it.
No.
Then the second one.
I don't want to say. Fuck.
Fuck or thing. Third. And it's better to have something you...
Roof.
Roof. I would say roof.
It's good if you can make an image of it. Yeah. So if it's the word boring, it's hard to imagine. So what is it?
Roof.
That's correct. The next?
Sun.
It's correct. And the last? You use also?
Ship.
Same.
Ship.
Ship. Sheep. Similar. And now you already translated it to words, so you have an image, you imagine this image, and can easier remember this number. Now we go in the other direction, because if you want to remember it, you have to go back. So what is cat?
Zero, 71.
Zero. Yeah, 71.
71? It's correct. Next one.
He's a hard to see.
You don't get it?
Not to
see. Okay, yeah. 85. Yeah, because 0 is a soft T computer.
Yeah. 85 is correct.
21.
21 is correct.
39.
39 is correct. And the last one?
41,
it's correct. So you know how it works? That's great. So in the internet you find already some lists and then books. But as you saw, there are different words possible. So you just print a list and you look at the words, and if you don't like a word, you have a better word for this number, you just change it. And you make your own list, and then you start to memorize it. And this system before, this rule, is just that you easier can memorize this. So, let's go to linking. Now you have a number with 2 digits, but you want to have bigger numbers, so you have to link this together. First, I give you an example how you can link. How you can link, for example, you have a key, what's a lock, a bicycle lock, and you have the pin. But how can you easily remember this pin? So, the number is also linking. We use now just a little different system. We just make a word with all these digits. So linking. And then when you go to your bank and you see your locker, you just look at it and think, I lick my locker. And if you have this imagine of licking your locker, you don't forget it.
What the hell is that?
Then, another example for linking. Now you had two numbers with two digits, which you want to link together. So you got the penguin and the shoes. How should it look like in your mind? Like a penguin with shoes. So I have some examples for you, and I want you to try to make these images, and after I will test you if you got it. So for example, you could make an image how you destroy your shoes. If it moves the image, it's more easier to remember, so make it, and it's much more easier as much more crazy it is. So make it not normal, make it crazy, like the penguin is swimming in this cup. So if you are ready, just show me your hand and we continue.
I actually can't see the images.
It's from a tree, thumbnail, something.
Pine.
And bottom.
Oh, there's arrows in there. Okay, I see.
So everyone has the pictures in mind. So we go. What's the link from the
hummer.
Shoe?
Hummer.
What?
Hummer.
The hummer?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Correct, the hummer. Next.
What was your image for this? Because I couldn't find it.
Yeah, I just pulled off the, how do you say, the pickle, and then just put the Tontopfen in it, just that the water can flow out. So just like it.
I imagined the pinnacle, or what is this? It's like an animal, and it's drinking water out of the bottle. It has eyes on the bottle. The pin is drinking water.
Do you know Pokemon?
Okay.
There's a Pokemon called Thumbs
Up. We go further.
Looks like Thumbs Up.
Penguin.
Penguin. It's also correct. So I think you got it. So we go to the lucky method. Now you were able to link two numbers. So you have a number with four digits. Or if you use the other example with the locker, you can also make like a bigger number. But it's not so possible to have a number with 200 digits. Else you would have to link many, many pictures, and it's horrible to remember. So you take the lucky method, where you have a visual route in your mind. For example, this is your hotel room. And you go just through the this your hotel room, and you go through the room in your mind, and you take a look at something, and then you link this place with your image. Then you go to the next point and link it. Next point, and then you have the order and the links. So the rule of this is it must be a familiar environment. For example, you can start with a route at your home. Normally start in a place where you mostly start. For example, if you go to work, the door inside to the company, or at home, the bed, you wake up. Then a clear order, you have to make a clear order, not make like a crazy movement, because you have to remember it, so make it clear. Then it must be memorable, don't take too heavy things, you think you don't can remember it. It must be medium proportions. Don't take like a gum from the office or just the big wall. Take like a fridge or a wardrobe, like something middle size. Then the distance is also important. Make it from 1 meter to 3 meters. Every 3 meters a new point. Then the permanent positions, take points which stay, so the wardrobe, this will stay forever, or sometimes you change it, but normally it stays in the same place. But if you take the water bottle, now it's here, but tomorrow it's there, so you cannot easily remember where it is. Then the difference, when you take three different bottles, it would be not so easy to see the difference between the links and which bottle you used. So take a very different stuff, for example, the wardrobe, the toilet. Then plane of view, you look from your eyes and not from above, or just from your eyes, like you're walking through the room. Then define the perspective in your mind. From where do you look? From which angle? Then number it. Make for every point a number. If you do it at home, you can take post-its and to memorize. Make everywhere the post-it 1, 2, 3, and then you go every day through it and you remember this route. Then we make an example. You wake up in bed of the hotel room, and now you link the bed with apples. We have a shopping list now. We want to remember 10 stuff, and try to make a link with the apple and bat. Tell me if you have a link. Good. Go further. Then you wake up, sit on the bed, and the first thing you see in front of you is the little black television. You make a link between the television and the toilet paper. Then you go further. There is, on the right of the television, is a tall, tiny green cactus, and you make a link between the cactus and chocolate. Then, normally, if you wake up, you go to the window and open the window, fresh air, and here you do the link with bubble gums. For an example, for me, I think about raining bubble gums. If you go on the way to the toilet, you see a little round table and link it with bananas. Then you go in the restroom and you go on the toilet. First you see the toilet, go on the toilet, link it with spaghetti. I throw the spaghetti from yesterday inside, for example. Then you go to the sink, wash your hands, and make a link with the sausages. Then you have a big luxury shower and have toilet paper. My link is now I have the shower full of toilet paper rolls, for example. Then you go to the wardrobe, take a dress, and link the wardrobe with the milk. And the last, you go to the door out of the room and link this with balloons. I open the door and whoa, so many balloons, you cannot walk outside. So you have already some links. because we are already over time, we have to go further. I hope you could remember it. So the last thing is language learning. It's a short thing. You want to imagine a pan. A pan is a metal container where you can cook food.
Thank you.
For those who don't know it. Now, you need also for language learning, you can also use links from images. So, Peter Pan has a pan in his hand. In English, it's the same word. But when you go from your language, like Pfanne in German, you search a word in the second language, which is this. You search a word in your language, which sounds similar like the second language word. And Peter Pan is a great example. I asked in Facebook some friends, translate it? And you want more? Yeah, I'm sure you want more. I got more and more, and I was not able to inside to do everything inside.
I think the sentence that's familiar with English, it's Netherlands.
Yeah, this is Netherlands.
Uh-huh.
And now it was really easy. You have the exact word. So, but it doesn't work every time. For example, you have the word fit, and you want to translate it to Spanish. Can somebody Spanish here? So if you want to translate this, it starts with ca and bear, ca bear, and you make the sentence, it's barely possible to fit a bear in a cup. And this is a crazy picture, and you will remember it. I never forget this anymore. So, that was my speech. You see, this was just a basic guidance. Now you can learn it yourself. I have some great stuff. He inspired me to learn this. Then I bought this book. It's in German, unfortunately. But I was looking for you, for the guys who cannot German. I think this book, memory book, is very similar with the topics. This book is great. It's also in German, unfortunately, only. But you can learn with this book English. There are 1,500 vocabularies inside, translated with images. And you have this also for French, Italian, Spanish. It's great. And I really recommend this application. You have all what I was telling you, all inside in this application. And you can learn this and you can also practice it. And this application is great to do your major system, because you can take the major system from the app and then change it as you like and memorize it, and it's a great app to memorize. So I'm at the end. I hope you liked it. I hope you were able to get something, and I saw you already know how to do it. I'm looking forward for your changes if you train this. And I just want to ask you if you still remember the last example. So does someone know the first
apple.
Yes. Great.
Cherry pepper.
Yeah.
Toilet paper. That's right.
Chocolate.
Right.
Bubble gum.
Yeah.
We have to know the way to follow.
Yeah.
Toilet paper again?
Toilet yes. paper, yes.
Milk?
Yeah.
Balloon.
You are great.
Yeah, oh, amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stef.